Here are 10 things every data analyst needs to know. And if you know these things, becoming a data analyst can be pretty easy, but without them, it's going to be harder than you ever expected. And actually getting a job is pretty much impossible without knowing these things, because it's just the way data analytics works. Let's not waste any more time and get right into it. Starting out with number 10, if you want to become a data analyst, you need to understand how to think and operate like one. It takes a certain mindset, you need to be able to think analytically about things, and you need to be curious. Now, some people are naturally like this and super curious, and that is great. But for most people, it's a skill that you have to practice, and you can always get better at this. Now, how do you exactly practice this skill? Well, there are many ways, like reading more, asking more questions, and actually trying to understand your surroundings, and being more observant. And of course, also learning and challenging yourself to think hard about things. Training your brain to think more efficiently or in a certain way is actually a real thing you can do with practice. When you get started, there'll be so many things you want to learn and focus on. But there's a reason why most online courses teach you a little bit about everything. It's because it's a great way to ease into the field. But also, it's a good idea to focus on learning the fundamentals of data analytics first. If you dive right into SQL, it might be a little bit demotivating, and chances are that you won't really understand why you have to learn all of this. Number 8. As soon as you get started, learn how to actually learn things in the best way. One of the most important skills is learning how to learn. And if you know this early, becoming a data analyst will be so much easier, just like anything else you want to do in life. Back in the days when you wanted to study something, you would have to get accepted to university or go to some place. It was a big sacrifice, and if you had a lot going on, or if you were struggling financially, then it was very hard to do so. But education has changed, and has become a lot more accessible and also a lot more fair. And there's really no excuse not to learn data analytics if you do want to become a data analyst. We have many powerful tools for learning today that previous generations would have killed for. I'm talking about low-cost or even free online courses, YouTube tutorials, articles, forums, and nowadays even AI. Anyone can learn anywhere as long as you put your mind to it. Number 6. Don't expect to get a job right away. Be patient, and the reason why is because success is not linear. It's not like you start here and then slowly reach the top step by step, which is in this case a job. Progress doesn't work like that. Progress goes like this. Nothing happens for a while, and then it goes up exponentially, then maybe it becomes stale a bit, and then keeps going up. Success is not going to be a straight line, and there will be many moments where you feel like you're not progressing even though you are. For example, if you learn a little bit of programming every single day, in a few months you will have gained a lot of experience, but you probably don't see it because you don't see the long-term progress. You only compare yourself to where you were yesterday. So don't give up, take it step by step, continuously improve, and be patient. Your portfolio is the number one thing that's going to help you land a job as a beginner. You don't have any experience, and you probably don't have that much education either, maybe just a few online courses. Your portfolio is the way to demonstrate that you have the skills employers are looking for, and it's therefore super important. It's basically the only way they can determine if you can do the job or not, and they don't want to take a risk, so the better portfolio you have as a beginner, the more job opportunities will be available to you. I guarantee it. SQL or structured query language is incredibly important, and it's how we deal with databases, and is a skill that's often ranked as one of the most important data analyst skills that employers look for. If you reach the interview stage, chances are that you're going to be asked a few SQL questions, so it's incredibly important. Honestly, it's not like you have to learn 10 different programming languages to become a data analyst, but it's really expected that you know SQL well. I recommend learning how to work with SQL and then also studying the terminology and some common interview questions specifically before an interview. If you do this, then you don't really have to worry about the interview, it's not going to be that hard. Python is a better option for most data analysts. Many have been introduced to R because of Google's Data Analytics Professional Certificate, which is for some reason using R. And don't get me wrong, R is a great language for statistical analysis, but the fact is that as a beginner, in 9 out of 10 cases, you're much better off learning Python. It's a way more versatile language, used everywhere, it's easy to learn as a beginner, and highly in demand for data analysts, even more in demand than R. So while this is a personal preference and it's up to you, I personally think learning Python is a way better option for most beginners. Number 2. The Tableau versus Power BI argument. I mean, just get over it. Both are great tools and in high demand. Pick whatever you prefer. Now, I prefer Power BI personally, and that is just a personal preference. I have no real reason as to why you should pick Power BI over Tableau. I'm sure that there are some different reasons, which I'm not an expert at, but I know people that learned either one of these tools and did great and got a job, and it's not going to be a problem. Although I do recommend taking an intro course on both of them so you know the basics, and you can also pick which one you want to specialize in and you prefer, or if you want to learn both, I guess you could do that too. finally, the last tip, that's probably the most important piece of advice that I can give you, even though it's so simple, is number one, enjoy working with data. If you don't do this, everything will be so much harder, and learning is way easier if you enjoy what you do. You learn way faster, you'll be much more motivated, and therefore get better results. You don't have to love everything about data, I mean nobody does, but consider if you actually like data science, if you like working with data, because people can tell when you're passionate about something. Your boss will understand, and your hiring manager will see it. Now there are different things in data that you can work with, people prefer different things, and that's completely fine, but I strongly believe that you need a fundamental appreciation for working with data to succeed in any data role. Those are my 10 tips to become a data analyst. Like this video and subscribe for more if you found this helpful, and check out this video next to learn more about how to become a data analyst.